Namaste, Count and Cook back again. Today I'm going to bring you yet another recipe from Mangalore. It is chicken ghee roast. It is also called as Mangalorean ghee roast or Kundapura ghee roast. This recipe originated in one of the restaurants in Mangalore who belong to Kundapura. The main essence of this recipe is the liberal usage of ghee. Typical of any Mangalorean cuisine, the preference is over whole spices to that of powdered ones. Before I get started, let me run through the ingredients. Here we are taking 1 1/4 kilo of chicken cut into medium sized pieces. Juice of 1/2 lime. Just a tablespoon of yogurt. 1 teaspoon turmeric powder. 1 teaspoon of red chili powder. 1/4 to 1/2 teaspoon of fenugreek seeds. 1 1/2 teaspoon of black peppercorns. 3 teaspoons of cumin seeds, 9 teaspoons of coriander seeds, 30 badgi red chilies, 1 tablespoon of jaggery, 1 teaspoon of fresh tamarind, 1 tablespoon of curry leaves, a small bunch of cilantro, 1 teaspoon of ginger and garlic paste, 1 to 2 tablespoons of garlic, salt as per taste. Last but not the least, loads of ghee. The first step in making chicken ghee roast is marination. For marination, take a deep bowl. First goes the salt, ginger and garlic paste, turmeric powder, red chili powder, yogurt, lemon juice. In goes the chicken. Mix the chicken nicely with the marinade. And rest the chicken for at least 1/2 hour. Next step is dry roasting the whole spices. Take a pan. In goes some garlic. Saute on low to medium flame. Next goes fenugreek seeds, black peppercorns, cumin seeds, coriander seeds. Now goes dried red chilies. Saute the mixture until the spices start leaving out fumes. Allow the mixture to cool down before transferring them into a mixture jar. Blend the spices coarsely like this. Add in tamarind and jaggery. By adding sufficient water, grind the mixture into a smooth paste like this. Melt some ghee in a pot. When the ghee melts, add in chicken. Now fry the chicken until it changes its color. Now transfer the chicken into another bowl. To the same bowl, add some more ghee. Now add in ground masala paste. Now keep stirring the masala continuously. Be careful, the masala splutters around, so adjust the flame accordingly. Now is the time to add some seasoning. Keep continuously stirring. Now is the time to add some water. Add water from the same jar that you ground spices in, so that the remnants don't get wasted. Keep on stirring the mixture until the fat starts to separate on the top. At this point, when the fat started separating on the top, that means the spices are well cooked It's now time to add some chicken. Now cook the chicken in the masala while continuously mixing so that the chicken gets a nice coating of the masala. In another pan, melt some ghee and fry some curry leaves in it. In the meanwhile, when the curry starts simmering, here goes cilantro. Mix well. You can adjust the seasoning at this stage. Now we can add in fried curry leaves. Now the same thing again and again. Keep on stirring on medium to high flame. Note of caution while making this recipe. The spices splutter a lot while making this recipe and there's no way around it. Because ghee roast is supposed to be a dry curry, so majority of the cooking is in open without the lid, so you would end up having a messy kitchen. Chicken ghee roast is ready. It is best served as an appetizer. The calorie density for chicken ghee roast is 178.2 kilocalories per 100 grams. For more such interesting recipes, subscribe to the channel Count and Cook. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up.